Welcome. 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 Welcome to B.Rich's Corner. Now, in today's first installation, first installment, if you will, of B.Rich's Corner, we're going to tackle something that people in our generation, which would be millennials, Y, X, whatever you want to call it. I'm 25. A lot of us are trying to go after our dreams. However, how can you go after your dreams when you're stuck in a society like this? You got Sally Mae loans, you got car payment, you got rent. You got all these other things that are new to you as an adult, you know, just truly walking into adulthood. So how can you still follow the same person that you were when you were 18, 19, 20, 21, when we thought the world was all cookies and cake, right? This is me doing that. But what is you doing that? What are other people doing that? I don't know. But today we're going to find out. We have two excellent guests. Two of these folks I've known for a very long time. A lot of you may know them. One is an excellent motivational speaker by the name of Douglas Hood. Let's give it up for him. All right. And the other is an excellent coach by the name of Jeff Smith. Both of these guys I've known since high school. Both of these guys are currently following their dream. You ever wonder what a dream looks like at its inception? You know, from its birth to its childhood years to its teenage years and then finally full growth. Well, we're looking at dreams, I'd say probably within going from childhood to right into that adolescence, teenage type of years. These guys are going after their dreams. They're doing what they love, how they want to do it. Now, how can people like you and I do the same thing? That's what we're going to figure out today. Thank you for joining me. Douglas, and I said, Mr. Hood, man, I see you out there speaking. I've been to a couple of his engagements. I've known the man for a long time. I said, no, you have got to talk to these people. You've got to let them know. What is it like to follow your dream? Because everybody has a dream. 10% of us probably follow. And I would say of that 10%, 10% probably actualize their dream. What do you think is the difference between all those different percentages? I would say perseverance. But let's see what Doug has to say. Welcome aboard, sir.
Born again. I was born again.
What'd you say now?
Ah, yeah.
And turn inside out. Yeah. Yo, look at that piece of art, bro.
Yeah, I've say that art.
A robotic dog, man?
Had to zoom in on that joint.
A robotic dog, bro. Okay.
What is your definition of chasing your dreams? What does that mean to you, Robbie? Doesn't mean anything to you. Doesn't matter.
Chasing dreams. I'd like to ponder on that for a quick second, if you don't mind, Tony.
And I'm while thinking, he ponders?
And I'm thinking.
Let me know when you're done pondering, sir.
Chasing, what is chasing that dream? I think chasing your dreams has more so to do with your heart, man, with what you feel. Because you can think a lot of stuff in your head. You think of your dreams mm-hmm. in your head, but I think that they're motivated through your heart. So every time when I wake up in the morning, the only reason why I'm able to chase and do everything that I want to do is because I'm doing it for something that's bigger than me. And that is aligned with my heart. I got on my visualization board, the thing in the middle is my family, you know what I'm saying, which represents more than just my family, you know, my main family, but my brothers and my close ones. So that's what wakes me up every morning at 4:30 in the morning, bro. Like, it's not because it's not the money that motivates me at all, but it's just the fact that as a man, I feel responsible for taking care of my family. So in order for me to do that, I know I have to do some massive things. And some of the massive things that are in my head are actually my dreams. But if it weren't for my family, if it weren't for my brothers, and it weren't for people that were close to me, and it was just me doing it for me, I don't think I would be successful at chasing my dreams, man.
Good answer, sir.
Yep, that's exactly how I feel, man. That's just how I feel.
How do you feel when you are going after your dreams, when you're going after what's in your heart?
Oh, man. This is all new. I wouldn't want to say it's all new, but the way that I feel, man, is really indescribable, man. It can bring me to tears, bro. I've been brought to tears a lot lately. You know what I'm saying? Because of the fact that I'm truly going after what I really want in life, man. What I really want in life, man, is to be able to inspire people. And I try to do that through speaking, but more importantly, try to do that through my life, man, through living. I think anybody can get up in front of a group of people and inspire them, but it's the real motivators, man, are the people that actually live what they speaking, man. And that's more challenging than getting in front of a whole bunch of people and speaking.
So, last question in this quick questionnaire, if you will. What does that look like to you as far as what does it look like to live what you speak? What do you mean by that? Like, how are you living what you speak?
How am I living, or you want me to tell you, like, what am I doing?
You take that question and you run with however you want. Okay. As we drive through a hood in Richmond.
Basically, yeah, we definitely did. I'm so used to this route. Basically, man, I live what I speak by making sure that if I'm gonna tell somebody something, if I'm gonna give somebody some advice, then it's my responsibility to myself to make sure that I'm following that advice myself. Because if I don't follow the advice and the inspiration that I give out, then I'm not being true to myself.
Okay, so what are some examples of that?
For an example, I just gave an entire seminar on how to be a servant leader, which is something that I aspire to do. And a servant leader is simply someone who serves first and leads second. So a real quick and easy acronym was called NICE. N standing for having Nike vision, having vision in your life and vision past the day-to-day operations. The I represents inspiration, being able to inspire people to continue to, you know, motivate them to get stronger and to do better. C representing consistency. Always trying to be, you know, on time, always trying to exemplify hard work ethic, and, you know what I'm saying, just trying to be consistent with whatever you're doing. And then finally, E, empathy, which means sharing and being able to feel what other people feel so that you can better serve them, so you can better inspire them, and you can better be a role model to them. And I just taught that to 60 people, you know what I'm saying, and it puts so much more responsibility on you to be thorough and to do what you taught. You know what I mean? Because if not, then you feel fake. You feel like, you know what I'm saying, you're a hypocrite, and much more negativity, in my opinion, man.
All right. I appreciate you, sir.
No problem, brother. Appreciate you, brother. Keep doing your thing.
My second guest of the day is Mr. Jeffrey Smith. His dream has always been to be a high school football coach. He's 25. Guess what he is? Nobody, huh? High school football coach. Doing an excellent job. Excellent job. Intelligent man going after his dream, capturing what he wants in life. Let's see what he has to say about it.
So I don't want you to get into the acting role, so I don't want you to be out shopping for a second here,
son. Son, I can't be out shopping, son. I don't have the hair for it, son.
All right, son. Mm. This here, Jeffrey. You know what? What am I doing? Introduce yourself, my boy. Welcome to my show, son. B.Rich's Corner. Very first guest at the corner.
Oh, all right. I'm honored to be the very first guest. It's great, son. Nice place you got here.
Thank you, son.
Like you said, my name is Jeff Smith.
Make sure you're loud now, son. We ain't got no high-tech shit, son. Act like you're coaching, coach.
As loud as it can be right now, son.
All right, I understand. You may not understand, but I understand.
Okay, son. Appreciate it, bro. Indeed, son. All right, I'm Jeff Smith, you know. I've known this cat since I was in, high school. No, middle school.
Middle school.
Middle school.
John Rowe.
Middle school. Football. Yeah. Anyway, yeah. I'm a graduate of Norfolk State University. I graduated with honors, cum laude. You know, not to, you know, boast myself. But it's a good, you know, it's a good achievement right there. So I played football there for 4 years. Got a scholarship there. And now I'm working, you know, disadvantaged kids.
Yes, they are. Like
and,
well, hold on now. Tell them what college you got accepted into.
I got accepted into Harvard. Would have went to Harvard, but, you know, the prices at Harvard are not in my price range right now. So
broke!
Or within, so, yeah. That was also a crazy achievement, you know, at the time, too.
Mm-hmm. All right, sir. So, this here series, my boy is focusing on following your dreams, doing what you want to do, how you want to do it, and following your heart. So, I just got a couple questions here for you. Mm-hmm. Well, really, it's four questions. A couple. Now, my first question for you would be, what are your personal feelings towards following your dreams? Like, what do you think about when you think about following your dreams? What does that mean to you?
Well, I think most people get caught up in the fact that I think they think that dreams are goals. Dreams and goals are two different things. I think dreams are something that your heart is telling you to go after. I think a goal is something that your mind is telling you to go after. Because you can see it. You can see the end result. So when I think of, you know, following a dream, I don't think of, you know, it's one dream. It's a lot of dreams that, you know, I want to do. They just come at different times in my life. Right now it's football and, you know, working with kids, you know, teaching them, trying to help them out. And because that's my heart right now, and I feel like if I leave it right now, I'm not completing my dream. I'm not, you know, cherishing the dream that I'm living right now, you know, that, you know, you just gotta follow with your heart, man. Follow your heart, man. And I think reaching your dreams or living your dreams is all about, you know, giving your heart and living it with your heart, enjoying it with your heart instead of your mind, you know.
Okay. Good words. You know, HTC on deck here, you know. So you've already answered the next question. I was gonna ask you, are you currently following your dreams? But obviously, man is currently following his dreams because he's following his heart.
Indeed. Like I said, you know, working with kids and, you know, especially disadvantaged kids because, you know, that's the place I work at. That's their last, you know, result. That's the last chance, really, before, you know, they get into the criminal system. So it's rewarding to help them out when, you know, everybody else is giving up on them. And, you know, and then coaching, man, it's just so rewarding in so many ways because you can actually see your hard work in a shorter period of time on the field and through, you know, wins. Not even wins, even the losses, the battles through losses, you know, going into overtime and, you know, with the number four ranked team in the state at the time. Double overtime. Holding their offense, which is one of the most powerful offenses in the region, average, you know, 40 points a game. holding the offense to, you know, under 40 points and holding the offense at under 100 yards. It's crazy, man. And that, it's crazy doing that, man, because it I guess I live it through that.
Last two questions here, my boy. Last one I gave you about good, put a good 37 to 45 second cap on that thing, son. Right. But can you do it, son? We're going to see if you can, coach. I'm going to coach him up, coach.
All right.
What motivates you? Go.
What motivates me? Passion. Passion. Passion for what I do. Passion for the way I live. Passion for, you know, the people that are living positive, you know, living the positive way and making my life a positive way in the same time because I'm surrounded by that positivity. So passion.
I'll give you a 30-second handshake, my boy. Insightful. Insightful. I can tell you that me doing this, me recording myself on camera, is something that I've been thinking about for years. Me making videos, me doing effects, me cutting the videos, putting different sound effects on them, video effects on them, transitions on them, things that I've always thought about doing. But what has stopped me? What has stopped me? I always try to figure in, how can I make money? Oh yeah, Brandon, you enjoy doing this, but how can I make money off of it? Oh man, you really have a good time doing that, but how can I make money off of it? And every time that I get to that conclusion, it stunts my growth within my dream. Why? Because your dream doesn't care about money. Your dream just cares about, what are you expressing? Are you expressing what you're supposed to express? You are here as a light to turn on another light, if not millions of other lights. But if your light isn't on, who then turns on the light that it is your job to turn on? That leaves the entire world dark, right? If 90% of us are walking around without our lights turned on, we're not actualizing our dreams, we're doing nothing. As okay, you know, we have a nice job, we're making decent money, but where does that leave your soul? Are you truly happy with what you're doing on a day-to-day basis? I'm not asking you, are you truly happy with where you live, what you drive, or how much you make, or how much debt you have? I'm not asking that. I'm asking, are you truly happy with what you're doing on a daily basis? We just talked to two guys that are following their dreams, they're following their heart. I didn't ask them, what do you do to make money? They didn't say, I do this because I know one day I'm going to make money. No. When you're following your heart, when you're following your dreams, you get what you're supposed to get out of life. And being that there's such a small percentage of us that are actually following our dreams, imagine the large percentage of resources, wealth, notoriety, things of that nature that you could possibly get by just exercising your talents. But even if you don't, at least you can die happy. Fuck that. At least you can live happy. That's what's most important. This week, decide, make a decision. Are you going to follow your dreams? Are you going to do what is innate and natural to you? Are you going to live in someone else's maze? Go to someone else's job every day and have that be it. Make someone else's money. Huh? Write someone else's book. No. Write your own book. Write your own book. Thank you.